And my name is Princely Glorious, also co-founder at Ona Stories.
So that day was an interesting time because when we got the call that we were in the finals. And then, but at the same time, that's also the time we were traveling to northwest of the country, Kigoma, and we were actually conducting a training about storytelling and communications to a UNHCR team in Kigoma. And so in between training, you know, I'm checking my email and all that and stuff. And, you know, they gave us the day in which they're going to be announcing the winners. And so we quickly gave the cohort classroom. That was there, the classroom, an exercise to do. That was important that they really think about this exercise while we dashed just outside and set up the computer to listen to whether we made it or not. And so
we had applied a few, not too long ago from that, the day we learned about it, we've done our presentations.
Right.
I was pretty confident that, you know, in this country, you know, we're going to be the ones to get it based on the strength of our application and the strength of the vision that we have for this. My team were like, let's pray, you know, jittery and whatever, but we did it.
The point is, this was rolls very fast. But no, we were extremely happy. We were extremely happy that, because personally, like as somebody, this was the first time I was actually applying. We were actually applying for something that, we saw, you know, that, you know, you hear people applying for things, you see them and you're like, oh, that's good for them. And so for it to happen, I've never won anything particularly in my life, actually. So for me, it was really such a big deal, such a big boost, because when I saw the application, when I saw the call out, I felt immediately called for it. I felt we were just the right fit for this and we would really get a lot from the program. So I was really, really happy. We're all very pleased.
Yeah, but on the day itself, it was huge excitement from all of us. We like Tula said, we gave the classroom a workshop, you know, like homework to do, so that we can step outside, and we, you know, got onto Skype, onto Zoom, and we were waiting for it. We were announced as the winners, and it was just ecstatic. We just screamed and shot. We have videos of this, like, from our phones. Just super ecstatic. Because of what we believe we can gain from this program, but then because of what we believe we can do beyond the program.
I think also for me, it was just being able to see that somebody else can see the validity of our idea, that thought that, okay, this is something to we can invest money in. And so that for me also was quite a big deal.
A lot of what we're looking forward to with the AKU Innovation Residency is to go back to our original goal of creating original content, original explainer content for Tanzania. We've already started learning about the Lean Model Canvas, the Lean Journalism Canvas, we've done human-centered design. That type of upskilling for ourselves as the leadership team for Ona Stories is providing, or taking us, for me at least, it's taking us back to where we had started, kind of helping us re-clarify our vision, helping us see where the gaps in our model might be, so that we can be able to deliver explainer content more powerfully and in a way that makes sense for this market. And then we want to do that not on our own, right? We want to bring in other Tanzanians. Like Tulanana was saying, the creative economy in Tanzania is nascent, it's booming, and it is the sector of the economy that can bring in all this different talent. Now, we see our role in this as the ones who create content from the future, essentially. We do virtual reality content, we create augmented reality content, we are experimenting with all these different formats from the future of storytelling. And our job is then to bring all these different players together and say, okay, here's a skill that you might need to use 2 years down the line. Here's a skill about mobile media that you might need to use today. Here's a skill about storytelling, about character-driven storytelling, story narrative arcs, all of those different techniques and skills that we can provide to young Tanzanians to support us and to help us explain this country to this country, you know, explain this country to its people.
As fellow young people, because we're so young, I'm like 25.